नमस्ते टू ऑल द फ्रेंड्स एंड इंडिविजुअल्स. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द फाइव सेंसेस. आई वाज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द फाइव सेंसेस एंड देयर फंक्शनैलिटीज, सात्विक गुण एंड सात्विक राजसिक एंड तामसिक गुणास, विच आर रेस्पेक्टिवली लाइक इल्यूमिनेटेड और लाइटेडनेस काइंड ऑफ, एंड राजसिक बीइंग द इम्पेलिंग बिटवीन डूइंग दैट इम्पेलिंग एक्ट बिटवीन सात्विक एंड तामसिक गुण. नाउ लेट मी टेक दिस मच very well sir, very well Ramchandra, you are speaking this way fine. What are the pramanas that you have? Definitely yes, many people will ask, they are supposed to ask. That's how you will come to know, right? I'm speaking correct or right or wrong, because every shastra has a pramana. On one hand, I'm speaking shrutis, telling that shrutis were existing 10,000 years back, and that were translated and transcribed after 10,000 years. Into Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharvana Veda, Sama Veda. So what is the base level or base study for this? Everyone will definitely ask, because I need to give the proof, right? So the proof for this is, we can say it as प्रामाणिकस, प्रत्यक्ष प्रामाणिक. प्रत्यक्ष हियर मीन्स द परसेप्शन दट केम टू द माइंड ऑफ द सीयर्स और सेजेस, ऋषिस, ब्रह्म ऋषिस एंड with their intuition they could see that, foresee that, and they tried to give that picture, visualize that, give the envision that in their conscious mind and create the final output in their subconscious mind. Now if thing is over to this extent, it would have been much better, but it has gone to an extent of anumana or inferences. What is the proof that this will work? This is right. Let's say a sound has come. What is that you are hearing? From where are you hearing? There has to be some pramanika, right, for this. So this is where they had that, you know, thought. What is that aspect that needs to be looked upon? Fine. So pratyaksha pramana is like perception. They created that perception and they tried to understand, well and good. Anumana also done. So they had experimented and they had tried to see that experimentation and found that they are hearing from the ears and that is coming out from the mouth. Shabda. Shabda pramanika. What is that? word and testimony. When I say Shabda, what is that Shabda? What is that, alphabet or word that is coming? That also needs to be taken care of, right? You just can't really rely on the Pratyaksha Pramanika or Anumana Pramanika. There has to be some base. There has to be factors and cofactors governing this as well. So Shabda is the one. And story does not end over here. Upamana. Upamana Pramanika. What is this Upamana Pramanika? It's like comparing and getting that analogy. Why comparison and analogy for this? When we talk about comparison and analogy, what happens is we tend to get certain ideas. And that's when you come to one analogy. It is not that you are like getting stipulated to that. Whatever inference that you are getting, imprecise. That's the reason why they had to get Upamana. And that's when they could come to a conclusion that this is the correct line, this is the correct way, and this is the correct structure, this is the correct system that needs to be followed. And thus they had to inculcate in Shastras. So what is it? How do they come to a conclusion? Can they come to a conclusion with one single statement? They need to compare with n number of statements, n number of situations. That's when comparison and analogy came into picture. Then came Anupalabdhi. Why this Anupalabdhi? See, I am talking about perception over here. I am perceiving one thing and giving the analogy, and I am giving those inferences with the support of the factors of the cofactors of the words or the alphabets or the bijaksharas, and I am transcribing into shastras, and I am like giving it as a final product. Why non-perception also came into picture? Understand this, friends. Non-perception is nothing but it's a scenario where what if people say this is wrong, what next? I may perceive it right, but society cannot perceive it right. By default, as a note and disclaimer, rishis, munis and brahma rishis had that futuristic vision that civilization would change, society would change, will change, and likewise everything changed centuries after centuries after centuries after centuries. That too in a period of, in a time span of 500 years. For every 500 years, centuries changed. However, yugas had its own calculation with the number But yugas do not have anything to do with the changes of the society or the civilization. As the civilization and society changes, likewise the habits also will change, shastras also will change. And that is one reason why, if you really see, they say in this yuga of if you tell a name of the god, that is enough. Whereas in Satya Yuga, you had to follow all the rituals, which was being followed in the Indic culture, Indus Valley civilization, and that happened. And in fact, Hinduism, if you really ask me, it may have started from Nasadiya Sutta or Hiranyagarbha Sutta time itself. However, additions or deletions may have happened, and they are bound to happen. If we really see the real Hindutva or real Hinduism, real definition of Hinduism, religion and spiritualism, if we really need to understand, we need to go back to Indic culture and Indus Valley civilization and Harappa civilization. Because as the centuries descended, maybe 3000 or 4000 years back, if I go, it was totally different. And if I go back 15,000 years back, it's like totally topsy-turvy. We need to understand that. And most importantly, they had one factor, one key point over here, that the body that is there, that is trying to understand all of this, pratyaksha pramana, anumana pramanika, shabda pramanika, upamana pramanika, anupalabdhi pramanika, is at a gross level. Once he or she crosses these, that's when he or she would be able to understand about illusions and delusions. Illusions and delusions. And that's when he would be trying to seek for the truth. We need to think at the gross level. Whatever that I am talking right now is at a gross level that I have spoken. To get to the conscious level or the conscious knowledge or the expressions that needs to be given, right, is again a further more step to all of these, whatever that they have it has generated. As per shastras. And that's when maybe these 36 tattvas came into picture, to understand this conscious knowledge of expressions. And that's when the conscious, semi-conscious, subconscious, super subconscious, all these levels came into picture. And this is where the Yoga Shastra also came into picture. That's the reason why whatever that we got as per Shastras, even before Natya Shastra came, It was a raw data, raw information that we had, which was at a gross level. And to introduce Natya Shastra, Natya as one of the Navanida Bhakti, and music as one of the Navanida Bhakti, or yoga as one of the Navanida Bhakti, or meditation as one of the meditation as one of the Bhakti Tattva, one needs to understand the five Pramanikas to reach to this level. However, the point is, he or she needs to undergo this level. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note, with the pointers and key factors being understanding the Pramanikas that are Pratyaksha, Anumana, Shabda, Upamana, Anupalabdhi. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Have a nice day ahead.